Hello, good afternoon, guys. This is a BLMOK game. This is the day number two countdown to the 2 day communication workshop, guys. Today I'm talking about this workshop. There was a day actually that I and my friend went to McDonald's. We were gonna buy the kids' meal, basically. What is called Happy Meal, that's their favorite. And then when we got there, unfortunately for us on that day, the kids were not in the car. So we had this challenge with what is this thing called? And then I went on saying we are looking to buy the kids meal. Well, I don't know what this person was hearing on the other side. Apparently, it couldn't really figure out what we are saying. My friends tried. I tried a couple of times and then, well, I gave up. I just said, okay, how about the children's meal? That didn't work. You know what? I was just totally confused on that day. What is going on here? But we only had to, I mean, we had to remember this thing because we couldn't get anywhere, without saying the Happy Meal is what we're actually buying. Why am I saying this? You know what? You would imagine why this person is not hearing what we're saying. Well, it's called cultural barrier. Okay, the fact that you know something from your own country, the way it's called, or the way you pronounce it, it doesn't mean that if you pronounce it here, people here will hear what you're saying. So the fact is that there was a cultural barrier we're dealing with here, in the sense of how this thing is pronounced. This is the reason why this person couldn't hear at all what we were saying. So here it is. These are some of the issues we're gonna be addressing. You could say it's about English, but it's not also about English. It is about the cultural barriers that foreign trained professionals face, when they're in Canada. I'll tell you something, the hiring managers, they do have some basic I would say basic requirement, or I would say expectations. It is that you should be able to communicate clearly so that your colleagues, your suppliers, your supervisors should be able to communicate easily with you. And I'm talking about fitting into the workplace, your invite, the workplace environment. These are some of the issues. A lot of the time is about that communication. It's about the soft skills, and regardless of the technical expertise, years, decades of experience that you have, if these things are not checking out for the hiring manager, you have some challenges there, right there. So we're gonna be addressing these issues at the workshop. A lot of people will tell me that, that it looks like this is expensive workshop. It's 2 days, people. It's 2 days. And then you know what? This traditionally, or I would say, I've heard from some of my friends who told me that this course, our this workshop would normally take about 4 weeks. Like, it's intensive. So Gloria is actually applying some innovative techniques that will allow us to be able to get this stuff, in 2 days. So it's very intensive 2 days. I'm talking about the price because a lot of people, are being assessed. They've been told that they have these issues, but they wouldn't just budge because it's expensive to them. Well, put a cost to the fact that you are not working in your profession right now. We're talking about a cost of about $6,000 on a monthly basis to you and your family. Because if you're working in a survival job and you are supposed to be an experienced professional here in Canada, then, well, maybe the cost you should be thinking about is the cost to your family. The fact that you promise your family that they're gonna have a better life here in Canada, but this thing is causing you not to be able to fulfill that promise, and now you're talking about the price of this workshop. Maybe you should rethink this. You should put this into perspective. I have a client, actually my first client on the job site, Kaizen, who I actually have to get a job, which is also it happens to be the job at the level that he left the home country. You know what? When I asked him, after he got his job, I told him, "What do you think about the fee that I'm charging you for the training, for you to be able to get a job in your profession?" Guess what? This was a person who actually thought it was expensive. He told me it was nothing. Because now he's been able to put into perspective that really what I'm talking about here, the price here, is really nothing when he considered the cost to him of not getting to work in his profession and at a level that he actually deserves, because he's somebody who has put a lot into his professional development, and he's had a lot of experience in his profession. The same thing applies to you if you are considering you're basically sitting on the fence because you thought this is expensive. Well, you need to think again, because it is really nothing, just like my client said. So we are gonna have this workshop here in Winnipeg. I don't want you to miss it because it's an opportunity that I don't know if it's gonna present itself again. So if you haven't registered or if you don't know yet about this workshop, I encourage you to click on that link there, and you would see the details of this workshop. Okay, so tomorrow I'm gonna be talking about something else tomorrow, which will deal with some of the techniques that Gloria has actually applied, which I've actually sampled, so I'm just gonna show you some of those so you know the type of things that we're gonna be working on. Guess what? A lot of information on the LinkedIn and all that on the internet. Okay, well, they are very entertaining information. If you wanna get some result, you need to do. You start with that. Forget about all those delusional information you see there on the internet or on LinkedIn. If you're not applying it, if you're not doing, well, it's just good for entertainment. That's what I would say. But if you're interested in doing and getting results, well, click on that link. You see the information and you see the details for the registration. Thank you. See you again. Bye for now.